Hello everyone, this is Nitpicky Nerd, and today I want to tell you a funny story about my nephew who loves Star Trek. He's almost 3 years old, and I made the mistake of showing him Star Trek, mostly the starships themselves, because anything that goes on inside the ships he wouldn't understand, because he's too little, and also it's all in English, and so he wouldn't understand it. And I made a few videos recently talking about my problems as a kid watching stuff like Star Trek, which I couldn't understand, because I didn't know the language yet, and the translation was off, I misunderstood things, and so I didn't even try to show him any stuff that takes place inside the ship yet. But I thought it would be interesting to see how he would react to the starships. And the first time I showed him that, I don't think he even understood what he's watching, but shortly after, he totally fell in love with that. He loves the Enterprise, especially the Enterprise D. And I showed him all the ships, and that's the one that he loves personally. I didn't force him to like that one specifically. It's my favorite one as well. But I showed him all the ships, and that's the one that he seems to love the most. And he loves the intro of TNG. He loves, especially he loves that moment when the ship goes to warp. He kind of imitates it with his hand, and he does the sound, and he runs around pretending that his hand is the ship. I also made the mistake of letting him play with my model of the Enterprise D, which of course he broke several times. But at least now it's able to do the saucer separation, which it wasn't able to do previously. And he even tried to do that after I showed him the scene of the Enterprise doing that. Then he tried to do it with the model, but after it broke a few times, now at least it's able to do that. So that's kind of funny. And there are definitely some positive things about showing him at this age. For example, he now knows all the names of all the planets. He knows the names of all the ships. Like, he knows Voyager, he knows every Enterprise by its letters, and so he knows the ABC now, because he knows the difference between Enterprise A, Enterprise B, Enterprise C, and so on, up until E. And so at least now he knows the ABC. He now knows all the planet names. He understands what space is, he understands what planets are, what Earth is, what the Sun is, and so obviously it is educational. The reason I think maybe I should have done this later is because I keep thinking, now he goes to kindergarten, I keep thinking maybe he will talk with other kids about that and they won't know what the hell he's talking about, and he wouldn't be able to play with them at that. And so maybe it would have been better off to make him fall in love with trains or cars or stuff that other kids would also understand, and they would play together. But I showed him the Enterprise, and now he can't get enough of it. Like, he keeps demanding more and more of that, and so every time I see him, he asks me to put on all the Star Trek clips, and I prepared some clips for him, which I even put on my other channel, like the compilation of the saucer separation. I originally made it for him, and then I put it on YouTube because I saw that no one else compiled all those clips, all the clips without the people, because he doesn't like those parts, he doesn't understand or care about that. He only wants to see the starships themselves, and so he loves the saucer separation, he loves all the parts of the ships going into warp. He also loves the Voyager. For a while, he even liked it more than the Enterprise, I think, because the intro of Voyager is kind of better. It has more stuff going on without just the titles. It has the ship itself jumping between planets more than in TNG. So for a while, he loved Voyager most of all. And that created the funniest situation when he noticed that spoons look like Voyager. So his parents told me that because I showed him Voyager, every time they try to feed him, he takes the spoon and he pretends the spoon is Voyager. And so he throws the food all over the place because of that, especially because the spoon needs to face downward. And then what I did was replace all the clips. I basically mirrored them upside down, just as I used to do in my TNG edits. So I did that with all the clips so that the ship will be upside down. And then when he will play with the food, with the spoons, he will hold the spoon in such a way that the food won't fall out, as it did. The problem is that it was kind of too late, and when I tried to show him the upside down ships, he kind of wasn't happy. His smile disappeared, and he was looking at that, and he was kind of shocked at that and demanded for it to be the right side up. And then I tried to explain to him, no, it's all in space, it doesn't matter, this is the way it should fly now, and all of that. No, he refused to watch it like that, he wants to see it in the regular way. And so it didn't work. And so my mistake was that I didn't think about any of this when I showed him, and maybe I should have shown him the ships flying upside down from the start, and then he wouldn't have played with his spoons in such a way that everything falls out and his parents are mad at me. So I just think it's a funny story. And by the way, I think that's how they invented Voyager. I think I heard somewhere when they were pitching Voyager, probably Rick Berman and some of the other producers, they were eating at a restaurant and they were discussing how should the next ship look like. And then one of them kind of took up a spoon from the table and he said, "What about this?" And then they just went with it. I think I heard it somewhere. It's a funny story, which I think is very possible. And so Voyager looks like a spoon, and then he noticed that, and so he loves to play with spoons, pretending that they're Voyager, and of course everything falls out of the spoon. And then I tried to show him the intro upside down, and he was totally angry at that. And nowadays he kind of likes it sometimes, like sometimes he wants to see it upside down, so he's used to it, and now he's smart enough not to drop all his food down. And he loves to play with my model of the Enterprise, which he broke a few times, and I had to glue it back together. And unfortunately, I couldn't find any suitable toys for kids who look like the Enterprise. Like, I couldn't find any soft toys or stuff like that that wouldn't break. I only find models, which are pretty expensive, and so that's kind of annoying to me a little bit that now I have to buy other models, which will also break probably. So if you ever see this model again in one of my videos and you notice that it's all glued back together, now you'll know why. And I decided to share this story simply because I think it's funny. And he really loves all those intros and he loves all the space clips. And by the way, there are a whole bunch of fan-made clips of the ships on YouTube, which are better than in any of the shows and which show the ships in long scenes. And so I often show him some of those and that way I can occupy him for a few minutes while I'll do something, and so this is very comfortable for me to do, to show him all these clips, because you know the intro is too short, only 1 minute, and the scenes always have the people in them, which I cut out to show him, like the social separation. And he absolutely adores all the starships, especially the Enterprise D. And also something funny, before I taught him the letters, before I taught him the difference between the different Enterprises, he once asked me to show him the Enterprise, and I showed him the Enterprise D, and then he said, "Not this one." And then he showed on his hand, like he often pretends that his hand is the Enterprise, and he kind of pinched the back of his hand and pulled it upwards and showing it to me, and I couldn't understand what the hell he's showing me. And then I suddenly realized that he's talking about the first Enterprise, Kirk's Enterprise, which had that little bump in the middle on the top of the ship. It has that little heel on top of it, unlike the Enterprise D, which is more smooth. And so I laughed really hard when I realized that's what he's showing me, that he wants to see the first Enterprise with the little bump, and so he demonstrated on his hand, so that's hilarious. And after that I taught him all the letters, and so now he knows the ABC and he recognizes every ship, he knows which letter it is, and he likes all of them. And he also loves the battle scenes with the Borg. He's kind of scared of the Borg cube. I sometimes play with him. I pretend like it's the Borg cube trying to catch him, and then he runs away, and his hand is the Enterprise and stuff like that. So really hilarious stuff. And maybe one day I'll put some of that on YouTube. I did film a bunch of scenes, but his parents don't really want him to be on YouTube. And YouTube itself also recently changed its regulations that showing kids can be problematic and stuff like that. So unfortunately, I cannot show any of this stuff to you at this time. Maybe in the future, and I'll definitely try to film some of his reactions to movies and to TV shows. I'm already kind of thinking of which movies or shows to show him at what age, what is the best to show him, and stuff like that. So he'll definitely grow up to be a Trekkie, probably. Even though I do try to expose him to other stuff as well, especially because I want him to be able to play with other kids, and most kids probably don't know what the Enterprise is and Voyager and stuff like that. So I want him to be able to talk and to play with other kids his age. So nowadays I spend a lot of time trying to get him to like trains and cars and playing with all kinds of other stuff and not just the starships all the time. But it definitely has its advantages as well. It makes him curious about space, about science, and how everything works. And so he's a very curious kid. And so, anyway, this was a kind of a funny personal story which relates to Star Trek and science fiction. And so I decided to tell it. Let me know what you think in the comments below and we can discuss it. Do you want me to tell other stories like that? Did you find this funny? Let me know in the comments. And I will see you all next time. Bye bye.